Okay, guys, ready?
Yeah.
This transmission is coming to you.
Move on it. Does anyone else copy me?
This transmission is coming to you.
You've got it.
This transmission is coming to you.
Big on 30, we are coming in with
at least one
of those other chemicals, and we will help with that team.
You know, I've done a lot of sequels, and this one feels like the best sequel yet. It's certainly the most physically difficult in terms of actual muscular strength and in duration, because rarely have I worked on a film where we had so many puppet shots all in a row. It's definitely been exciting. We've been working with definitely up high. I think the clock tower was set working about 15 feet up, so we're all in full harnesses and tied down to things. I'm not used to puppeteering in a blue suit and with a full harness on.
Look out! So,
see? Safety issues always around here.
I designed and built the delivery device section that goes onto his body, the rib cage section, and also the spine and the needles. And as well as some of the control electronics for the piano hand that Khan built. Funnest parts was making the needle gag for the delivery device, the needles going into his spine. There are 38 needles that have to look like they go into his spinal cord and interface with his nervous system. And to make those sneak around a little corner and shoot down to where the motors, the actuators are, that was a little bit of a trick.
Because if it wasn't for us, no one could see anything. They'd be looking at a film. Could you imagine Sam out there holding up a print? I got it. It's not going to happen. No.
Some of the coolest things you ever saw. Big, giant spider webs. And Chris, the stunt guy's up there climbing on it right now. It's really great. Very cool.
I puppeteered the Death Flower Claw because I built it. We got an animatic about what the thing was supposed to look like, and I figured out how to make it work and made some drawings and machined some test parts and put together one finger of the claw and figured out that it would work and did a second generation of drawings, and we sent them off to have them CNC'd, and they came back and I assembled them and they worked great. It's kind of like bicycle brake cable technology. It's a steel cable inside of a conduit, inside of a liner. You pull on one end of the cable and something happens at the other end. It goes around pulleys inside the claw and it works.
really hard on your body. On a, you know, superhero kind of movie like this, you don't just go along for the ride, which is 9 times out of 10, is a ratchet. You go through the glass, you hit the wall, and that's it, you're dead or knocked out or whatever. This one here is, you have to be animated and do certain things and all these different movements, and it takes a toll on you after a while, but luckily we got through it good, and they finally, the last take, had all the hands in the right spot, and that was good. You know, I'll have sunglasses on and the whole wardrobe, but I look a lot like the guy, but they're giving me a bigger nose, so I'm anxious to see that, if it works better or not, because it's bigger than mine.
Dangle perilously over the edge of some sort of scissor lift, condor lift, something like that, holding a heavy tentacle, moving at an accelerated pace towards a stuntman hanging from wires while there's explosives set to rig and blow the clock arm in half. That's a one-take gig. One take.
Sounds really cool.
No pressure. Call one take wonder in the business. I got up there and I knew the task ahead of me, and I nailed it one take, breaking the tentacle in the process, but that's okay.
Brad, that was really good, but I won't do it again.
Standing in for Doc Ock has been an absolute treat every day. I've been on this project for months now, learning a lot, working with the tentacles, learning a lot just by watching. Puppeteering is a lot harder than I would have initially given it credit for. Standing in for Doc Ock has given me the strongest lower back in Hollywood, and you know, having a lot of fun.
Actually, a really easy set. Sam's an easy director. Alfred's an easy actor. Most interesting aspect is that actually doing more puppet shots than I would have expected. More physical, practical puppet shots than I would have expected. I think, obviously, based on movies like The Hulk and movies that are heavily in CG that don't rely on physical stuff, that obviously people can pick it out. It doesn't read as realistic.
Pretty exciting. That's one of the bigger films I worked on. A lot of really very qualified people, especially engineering-wise. Some of the very elaborate sketches, they actually work out mechanically, so it all works, all functions. The nice thing is they're doing a lot more practical tentacles, practical effects with the puppets.
Whip is for the camera. Grab is the cue for the tentacles. You grab a hold of Toby's shoulder. It shudders, he jolts, and yank. We yank him out of frame.
Action!